Isaiah chapter 48.
Isaiah chapter 48.
Verse 17.
Verse 17.
Isaiah 48. Verse 17.
Isaiah 48, verse 17.
And please don't ever come to the Holy Ghost service again without your Bible.
I beg you, make una not come Holy Ghost service without una not bringing a Bible.
You need the Word of God.
Una need the Word of God. Though.
You must come with your Bible.
Make una they come with your Bible.
If you are here with your Bible, wave it, let me see.
If you come here with your Bible, more than I carry them up, make I see.
Okay. That's not bad. Wave it so that you make the devil mad. Wave your Bible.
Wave the Bible, make you make the devil vex.
That's the sword of the Spirit.
I won't be sword of the Spirit too.
Glory be to God.
Glory be to God.
All right. Isaiah 48, verse 17.
Isaiah 48, verse 17.
And while you are opening your Bibles to Isaiah 48, I want to thank God for my son who spoke before me.
As soon as they open our Bible to Isaiah chapter 48, I want to thank God for my picking when I come talk before I come to talk too.
As usual, he did an excellent job.
You try well, well, well.
I give glory to God for all these wonderful boys.
I thank God for all these wonderful boys.
Isaiah 48, verse 17.
Isaiah chapter 48, verse 17.
Thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer.
Now say God talk, our Redeemer.
The Holy One of Israel.
The one where holy for Israel.
I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit.
Now maybe your God, where can they teach you how you tell them make profit for life?
Which leadeth thee by the way that thou shouldest go.
Now me can lead you for the place where you go follow.
I'm the Lord thy God, we teacheth thee to profit.
Now me be God, oh, we can teach you how you tell make profit.
To profit, not to lose.
To make gain, oh, not be to lose, oh.
The word loss is a horrible word.
This word when they call loss, now bad word be that.
If you engage in the competition, say football match, and you are defeated.
If you can't play football and they can't win on a team,
what is the word they use?
Now which kind of word do they use?
They say you have lost.
You just say you don't lost.
If you fight a war,
if you can't fight war,
and the enemy overcame you,
and the enemy can't beat you well, can't win you,
they say you lost.
You just say you don't lost.
If you travel,
if you can't travel,
and you can't locate your way back home,
and if you can't find your way come home,
they say you are lost.
You just say you don't lost.
If somebody precious to you should die,
if person when you like where we're gonna die,
they say you have suffered a loss.
They say, oh, you don't suffer a loss too.
In the name that's above every other name,
big pass every other name,
the word loss will get out of your dictionary today.
This word when they call loss though, you not go day your dictionary at all.
God says, I teach you to profit.
God can't tell us, say he teach us to make with the make gain.
To profit.
To prosper.
Not to lose.
Make with not lost at all. Make with make gain.
And the first point I want to make,
the first thing we say
tonight, is that your lips can determine your future.
Now with your mouth, your feet talk what is going to happen to you.
Your lips.
Your mouth.
Numbers 14, verse 28.
Numbers 14, verse 28.
Numbers 14, verse 28.
Numbers 14, verse 28.
God said,
God does say,
whatever I hear from you,
say, what he hear from you,
will determine what I will do to you.
Say, now go feed, tell what he go feed, do for you.
You know the story. Moses sent some spies to go and spy the promised land.
When I can't know the story, Moses so concept some people may like go look the promised land.
12 of them.
There be 12 people when they send go.
They returned. 10 of them said,
the 10 of them come to say,
even though the land is good,
even though the land good well,
it's a land flowing with milk and honey.
Food plenty, yafu.
He said, but we can't go in.
The land will not go free, go inside.
It can't be ours.
We never free, be our own.
The two of them,
the two people,
Joshua and Caleb, said, ah.
Joshua and Caleb, they come to say, ah.
They are meat for us.
These people are meat for us.
We can make it. And the Almighty God spoke to Moses and said, those who said they cannot make it will not make it.
God tell Moses, say, those people when they're tossing, they're not going to enter there. He said, they're not going to enter.
Those who said we can make it shall make it.
Say, those people when tossing, they're going to enter. Say, they're going to enter.
Tell somebody, my tomorrow will be all right.
Let you tell someone, say, my tomorrow go better.
Mark 11 verse 23
says,
if you say to the mountain, mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea.
If you go tell one mountain, say, mountain, no, make you move, come up from this place, make you walk, I go enter the sea.
He said, if you don't doubt, just say it to the mountain. He said, the mountain will obey.
If you not get that for mind, and you just tell the mountain, he said, that mountain will obey you.
In other words, he said, when you are praying and you believe, then you will have whatsoever you say.
Don't say, if you can't pray and you can't believe what you pray, he said, you go can't see the result of what you pray about.
Whatsoever you say.
Anything when you talk.
Proverbs chapter 13 verse 2.
Proverbs chapter 13 verse 2.
Proverbs 13 verse 2.
Proverbs 13 2.
It said, a man shall eat good by the fruit of his mouth.
Man go eat the good thing when they come out from his own mouth.
By the fruit of his mouth.
He said, by the good thing when they come out from the man's mouth.
Proverbs chapter 18 verse 20.
Proverbs chapter 18 verse 20.
Proverbs 18 verse 20.
Proverbs 18 20.
Says, a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth.
A man belly, you see now, wait till he talk, go to make him belly full.
A man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth.
What a man talk, oh. Now he's a fully belly.
That's interesting.
That one, they're very fine, though.
He didn't say the fruit of his hand. He said the fruit of his mouth.
He not also what he hand they bring. He said, but what he mouth they talk.
Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21.
Proverbs 18, verse 21.
Proverbs 18, verse 21 says,
Proverbs 18, verse 21 says,
death and life are in the power of the tongue.
For one to die and to live. He said, "There the power inside our tongue.
Whether you live or die is to be determined by your tongue.
Now your tongue will fit tell whether you go live or you go die."
In 2 Kings chapter 7.
2 Kings chapter 7.
From verse 1 to the end.
From 1 go reach end.
2 Kings 7 verse 1 to the end.
2 Kings 7 from 1 go reach end.
A man of God said,
one man of God come to say,
in less than 24 hours there will be abundance.
Before 24 hours time, he said, food go there, yafu, yafu.
A counselor of the king.
Someone can they advise the king.
A learned man.
No way, no book, where well.
A great academician.
No way, go school, where well.
Said, even if God were to open windows in heaven, can this thing be?
Said, even if God can't open window when they heaven. He said, this one, they're possible.
The man of God said, fine.
The man of God come to say, it good though.
You will see it. But you won't eat of it. And the Bible tells us that when the abundance came,
the Bible can't tell us, say, when the food can't come, yafu, yafu.
And people were rushing to take their share.
And people can't hurry, go carry their own.
They trampled the man to death.
See, they can't match the man for grand.
He saw it, but he never ate of it because he said, this thing can't be.
The man see him, but enough he eat out of the food because he thought, say, enough he happened.
In 2 Kings chapter 4.
2 Kings chapter 4.
Verse 18 to 37.
18 to 37.
2 Kings 4. Verse 18 to 37.
2 Kings 4. 18 to 37.
The Shunammite woman.
The woman who come from Shunammite.
I'm sure you know her very well.
I believe so, and I know her very well.
Who chose to entertain a man of God.
When God choose to take care of one man of God.
Build a house for him.
And God build one house for the man of God.
A man of God prophesied into her life.
The man of God, God prophesied for this woman's life.
And she had a son.
This woman gets one boy picking.
And suddenly the son died.
And in order to take, this woman boy picking can't die.
And the woman said, "Death, you are joking."
The woman can't say, "Death, oh, now play the play."
Took the child, laid it on the bed of the man of God.
Don't carry this boy picking. Come put it on the man of God there.
Told the husband, "I'm going to see the man of God."
God tell the husband, say, "Are they going to see that man of God?"
The husband says, "It's not the end of the month to say you are going to pay your tithe."
The husband can say, "Month end of Irish year, when you say you won't go pay tithe."
It's not a, they're not having a convention.
Say they not get convention now.
Where are you going there?
Then why you can't go there?
She said, "All will be well."
The woman can say, "Everything, no, you go there better."
The man of God saw her coming. Woman,
say, "Woman,
how are you?" She said, "All will be well."
He said, "All go better."
"How is your husband?" She said, "All will be well."
The man of God asked him, "How your husband now?" He said, "All go better."
"How is your son?" She said, "All is well."
He said, "How your pikin?" He said, "All is not better."
She brought a child back from the jaws of death by what she said.
I picking not die again because of what she talk.
You will remember the testimony of my daughter.
When I go can't remember the testimony when one of my girl picking talk.
Pastor Tosin Macaulay.
Her name is Pastor Tosin Macaulay.
She had a horrible accident in Zambia.
She get one bad accident, motor accident for Zambia.
Head-on collision.
The front light is jam.
Car total right off.
The car went, they say she did drive. Cut up beyond repair.
Her head broken in several places.
This pastor head, though, he break into different places.
Several other bones broken.
Her bone for her body break plenty.
Several injuries.
She get many wounds for her body.
They took her to the hospital.
They don't kind of go.
And they phoned me. "Daddy, we are sorry to tell you."
The doctor say, "Daddy, we sorry, sir, we tell you this word, though.
Your daughter had an accident and there's no way she could survive it."
One of your daughter get accident. I will not believe, say, she go fit survive this one.
You remember the testimony?
I believe when I remember this testimony.
What was my reply?
What is my reply?
I said, "Na lie."
I thought, "Na lie."
"Ah, Daddy, we came out of the hospital to phone you."
"Now from the hospital we just come, they phone you."
"We're not even sure she's still breathing."
"We're not there sure whether she still breathes."
I said,
"I thought so, na lie."
"Na lie."
"Na lie."
"When they phone later."
"They got phone later."
"She's in a coma."
"The doctor says she just asleep. She not open her eye."
"The doctors have said that even if she comes out of it, she will be a jelly for the rest of life." I said,
"The doctor can't say, even though she can't come out from this sleep, she go there useless for the rest of her life." I thought, "Say na lie."
"Stand on your feet.
Stand.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God.
You open your mouth, talk to God."
I said, "Father."
Gonna say, "Father,
hear me loud and clear.
Hear me loud and clear.
I hereby decree.
I can't decree.
My tomorrow shall be all right.
My tomorrow go there better.
Come on, open your mouth and cry to the Almighty God.
We gonna open our mouth when I cry, go meet Baba.
Hear me loud and clear.
Hear me loud and clear.
My tomorrow shall be all right.
My tomorrow go day better.
I decree, O Lord God Almighty.
I decree, O Lord Almighty.
whether the devil likes it or not.
Whether the devil don't like him or not.
My tomorrow will be all right.
My tomorrow, he go do better.
My tomorrow will be all right.
My tomorrow will be better.
I'm not going to fail. I'm not going to fall.
I'm not going to fall.
My tomorrow will be all right, Lord.
Tomorrow will be better, oh God.
I declare it loud and clear.
I can't talk and very loud.
Hear me, oh Lord. Hear me.
Hear me, oh God. Hear me.
I'm saying it now.
And they talk and now.
I want the heavens to hear.
I won't make heaven hear me.
I want hell to hear.
I want hell make it hear.
I want my friends to hear. I want my enemies to hear.
I want my friends made a hear. I want my even my enemies made a hear.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow, it go day better.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow will be better.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow will be better.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow will be better.
Oh yes, my tomorrow will be alright.
Yes, sir. My tomorrow will be better.
Whether the enemy likes it or not.
Whether the enemy can't like him or not.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow will be better.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Baba.
Thank you, Almighty God.
Thank you, Almighty God.
I declare it loud and clear.
I can't talk am loud and clear.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow, you go do better.
My tomorrow will be alright.
My tomorrow, you go do better.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God and say, Father.
Make una call open on our mouth. Make una talk say, Father.
I hereby declare.
I talk say.
This will be the best year so far in my life.
Now this year go better pass to my life.
Go ahead, tell the Almighty God, let him hear you.
Make una talk to God. Make una let God make him hear una.
Let him hear you.
Let him hear una.
Tell him.
Make you tell him.
I hereby declare.
I don't talk so.
This is going to be the best year thus far in my life.
Now this year go better pass all the years for my life.
I don't care what the newspaper may say.
Care what the newspaper can carry.
I'm not interested in what the economist may say.
I don't get interest for what the economists they talk.
I don't care what any prophet may prophesy.
I don't care what any prophet they talk.
I declare.
I can't toss it.
This year is going to be my best year thus far.
This year, that will be my better year past other years.
This is going to be my best year thus far. I declare.
And this year go better past every other year. I don't talk am
loud and clear.
I don't talk am loud and clear.
Let the heavens hear me.
Heaven know make una hear me.
Let the devil hear. Let all the hosts of hell hear.
Devil make you yell. Every devil when they hell make una yell.
This is going to be my best year thus far.
This year go better pass all the years.
I'm going to succeed this year like never before.
Oh, make and this year pass other years.
I'm going to greater heights.
I will go prosper this year.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, this is going to be my best year thus far.
In the name of Jesus, this year I go better pass every other years. For my life.
My best year.
And this one will be my better year.
Thus far.
So far.
This is going to be my best year thus far.
And this year go better past all the other years.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Glory be to God.
Glory be unto God.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' name we now pray.
And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
Now so it will be in Jesus' name.
God bless you. You may be seated.
God bless you now. Make una sit down.
You started very well. I like the way you prayed.
When I start well, though, I like the way that they pray.
Your mouth can determine your future.
Now your mouth will fit tell how far you will go for life.
I've told you those days when things were very hard for me and my wife.
I've not told you that before. That time when we said things were hard for me and my wife.
And Pama was our favorite meat.
Now show what be the meat we would like pass.
And the two of us used to struggle. You know, one Pama can be thicker than another.
Both of us can't struggle. You know, say some showboy, he get body past the other one.
When we see a thick one, we say this one is too thick. Don't eat it alone. Let's cut it into two.
When you can see the showboy when it thick past the other one, you say, this one too big now. Make we divide that into two.
And I will look at her then and I will say, my dear, we're not going to die like this.
I can't look my wife, I can't tell her and say, dear, we're not going to die like this. So.
Our tomorrow is going to be alright.
Our tomorrow will be better.
Say it one more time. My tomorrow will be alright.
We're going to talk him again. Say my tomorrow will be better.
Number two. There is power in agreement.
Power though, if people agree together.
Power in agreement.
Power though, when it's an agreement.
Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9 to 12.
Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9 to 12.
Ecclesiastes 4, verse 9 to 12.
Ecclesiastes 4, 9 to 12.
The Bible says two are better than one.
The Bible just says, two is better pass one.
And that threefold cord is not easily broken.
He said three things when they're together, you know they easily if it's scattered around.
Matthew 18, verse 19. Jesus Christ said, if two of you shall agree.
Jesus Christ come to say, if one or two can agree.
As touching anything you ask on earth.
Concerning anything one I ask for earth.
It shall be done for you by our Father in heaven.
He said, God, when the heaven know, he could do one for you.
Anything.
Anything.
As a mathematician.
As when we say, Sabi Mass, where we know.
I was trained to look for certain words when I'm about to solve a problem.
They teach me make I look for a word when I can use to solve a particular problem.
Words like all.
Some of the words not like all.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Anything.
Anything.
They determine the solution to the problem.
Now they go fit tell you the results when you go get.
Here, the Almighty Jesus said, if two of you shall agree.
For yeah, Jesus Christ come to say, if two of you can't agree.
As touching anything you ask on earth.
Concerning anything when they this earth.
It will be done for you by my Father in heaven.
My Father when they heaven know, he could do one.
And he gave the reason why.
He can't give the reason.
In Matthew chapter 18 verse 20.
Matthew 18:20.
He said, because where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in their midst.
He just said, if two people or three people, they can't dare together for God's name. He said, he can't dare with them.
That's why I pity those who sit down at home.
I can't serve for people when they are so.
So lazy they can't come to the Holy Ghost service.
They can't lazy, so they don't have to come to Holy Ghost service.
They want to sit down at home, Some of them want to watch it on television.
Many of them can't sit for us, they won't watch them for television.
So that while we are praying, they are sipping tea.
They won't come there, they pray. They won't come to drink tea.
God have mercy.
God will make you sorry.
Oh, you say, why do you put it in on television then? Why do you put it on internet? It's for those who are far away.
You're going to ask, okay, why you can't put up? Why you can't the show for TV? Why you can't the show for internet? The reason be say that for people when they're very far.
They are watching us now in Australia.
Some people there, Australia, they watch us.
They are watching us in Papua New Guinea.
Some people there, Papua New Guinea, they watch us.
They are watching us in Haiti.
Some people there, Haiti, they watch us.
Those people, there's no way they could come.
You know, we get the way those people will feel come this place.
So we need to go to them.
So we ourselves, now we will go meet them.
But. For you to live in Lagos, live in Ogun, live in Oyo, live in Ondo.
Oh, now where can they live for Lagos? They live for Ogun. They live for Oyo. They live for Ondo.
And say you can't come?
And you can't say you're not going to come.
I just pity you.
I'm sorry for now.
No. A tragedy occurred.
One bad thing can happen.
Towards the end of last year.
Well, last year.
That caused my heart to bleed as a father.
Don't make my heart to bleed as papa.
The Congress was on.
We came here for Congress.
The fire of God was coming down like nobody's business.
The fire couldn't come down like say not send anybody.
Demons were running out.
Demons couldn't take razor.
And do you know that a family sat down in their home in the camp watching the program on television?
And I can't go say what family they're there inside this camp, they can't watch the program for TV.
The fire of God was burning here.
The fire of God will in the burn for here.
And when death came knocking at the door, they were at home.
And when death, when they knock for their door, they ask.
I beg you, as a father.
I can't beg you now, as papa.
That kind of comfort that won't allow you to be in the presence of the Almighty God.
That kind of enjoyment won't go make you not go there God's presence.
That won't allow you to be where fire of God is burning. That kind of comfort should get away from you.
Make that enjoyment make it leave your body.
Where two or three are gathered together and look at us.
Where two or three people can't gather together, make on and look at our number.
We're not two. We're not three.
We'll not be two. We'll not be three.
We're not 200, we're not 2,000,000, 2,000.
We'll not be 200 though, we'll not be 2,000.
At the very least, we're hundreds.
In short, we're there in hundreds.
Of thousands.
Of thousands.
So I'm not asking you to come because there's no crowd. No, 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 it's for your own good.
I'm not asking you to come here because no crowd. No, not for my good.
Where two or three are gathered together in my name, he said, I will be there.
He said, where two or three people come gather for my name, I'll be that place.
Because there's something called corporate anointing.
Because something there, when they call anointing, when they cooperate.
Anointing.
Anointing when corporate.
When there's plenty of wood in the fire gets hotter.
When many wood come there inside fire, the fire becomes hot.
When people gather together and they are in agreement.
When people gather together and they agree with themselves.
Oh. When I go all over the world and they ask me to speak to ministers.
When I can't travel, go all over the world and they can't tell me to speak, I talk to pastors.
In various nations.
Or different nations.
And I want to challenge them to be united. I always tell them that in mathematics we have certain numbers that have similar properties.
Don't tell them, say for mathematics, so we get number, we get the same papa and the same mama with another number.
Don't be afraid. I'm not here to teach you mathematics. And we put them together in what we call sets.
Put them for one thing they call sets.
For example, every number that can be divided by two.
Every number when you go feel used to divide.
What do you call it?
Which one they call them?
At least you know enough of mathematics.
Listen, I know small mathematics.
When a number is divisible by two, you call it an even number.
If you feel used to take divide number, that number will they call an even number.
So we have what we call the set of even numbers.
So we don't get one set, what do they call even numbers?
I said in the spiritual realm.
In the spiritual realm, we get one set, what do they call set of the Almighty?
There is what we call the set of the Almighty.
Set of the Almighty.
And there are only three people in that set.
And there are only three people come inside this set.
God Himself. Psalm 91 verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High.
This when be say he can't stay for the place of God.
Shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
You can't stay under God.
And what is the meaning of Almighty? The one who can do anything.
Now what does Almighty God mean? He said, person when go feel do anything.
The second person in that set is a man of faith.
The second person when come there inside that set, now man when gets faith.
Mark chapter 9 verse 23.
Mark 9 23.
Says, if you believe, all things are possible to him that believe.
They're possible for person when they say it believes.
If you are a man of faith, you can do anything.
If you be a man when you get faith, you can do anything.
The third group of people in that set are people who are united.
There are three persons when they that set that people when they say they cooperate with each other.
Genesis 11 verse 6 says, God looked down from heaven.
Oh.
When human beings were trying to build the Tower of Babel.
When people for this earth, that time, when they build one big ass, one tall ass, what they call Tower of Babel.
God looked down from heaven and said, hey, these people are of one language. They are of one mind.
God looked down from heaven and God said, these people are one language and they speak. Oh. They get one mind.
There's nothing they want to do that they won't be able to do.
Don't get anything they want to do that they won't be able to do.
God said when people are united, even God Himself can't stop them.
God can say if people can't cooperate together, if God is not going to even stop them.
When we come to the Holy Ghost service.
When we come to Holy Ghost service.
And we pray in agreement.
And we can cooperate, pray together.
No devil, no demon, no witch, no wizard can hinder such a prayer when we are united.
If we stop the prayer when we cooperate with each other.
Prayer of agreement.
Prayer when we cooperate.
In 2 Kings chapter 7 verse 1 to 11.
2 Kings chapter 7 verse 1 to 11.
2 Kings 7 verse 1 to 11.
2 Kings 7 1 to 11.
Four lepers were in agreement.
Four people when they suffer for leprosy, they can't agree together.
Four lepers.
Four people when they suffer leprosy.
They were in agreement. Let us go to the camp of the Syrians.
Cooperate together. It's like we go the camp of the Syrians.
And because they were agreed, they lifted the siege on their nation.
Because they agree, they suffer when the people they suffer come up from ground.
Mark chapter 2 verse 1 to 11.
Mark 2 verse 1 to 11.
Mark 2 verse 1 to 11.
Mark 2 verse 1 to 11.
Four people in agreement.
Four people were going to agree together.
Brought a man who was paralyzed from neck downwards to Jesus Christ.
They can't bring one man when they say he paralyzed from the neck, go reach down. They can't meet Jesus Christ.
And the man got his healing.
That man man, Jesus called Elam.
They were united.
Those people, they cooperate.
Otherwise, when they got to the place and there was no room at the door.
Because if they can't come to the place and they can't find and say, they're not going to pass through the door.
One of them could have said, I'm no longer interested.
One of them said, well, I'm not tired, they go.
But no, no, no. The four of them were determined. We will get this fellow to Jesus.
It did not be like that. All of them can't say, ah, we go take this our brother and go meet Jesus.
They did. The man got his healing.
They can't do that. And the man, God can't heal the man.
Prayer of agreement.
Prayer when we cooperate.
We're going to pray a prayer of agreement in a moment.
We'll pray cooperation prayer.
I just want to remind you the power that is in agreement.
I want to remind you now the power when they work on the cooperation.
I'm going to tell you stories we've had before, so I'm not making them up on the spot.
We'll tell you a story one another year before, and then I try to form the story.
A daughter of mine came to me.
One of my pikin come meet me.
Said, Daddy, I'm pregnant.
You can't tell me she had belle.
I said, congratulations, because she was married.
I can't tell her, I said, congratulations, so, because she's not married.
He said, that's not why I'm here.
It's not be the reason why make me come. Huh?
Okay, why are you here?
I can't tell her, I said, okay, what's it make you come?
The pregnancy is 3 months.
He said, this my belle are 3 months old.
I said, yes.
I said, okay.
And I want the baby to be a girl.
He said, I want the pikin when they say this my belle make it be a girl.
My dear, the little science I know.
I can't tell her, say, my pikin, no. The small science will like, no.
Something I read in one of the bulletins of medical journal.
Something when I read for doctor book.
Says.
It does say.
Everything a child is going to be is determined within 72 hours of conception.
You say everything when we say pikin go be. 72 hours when B say the mama and the papa meet, it can't lead to pregnancy and the pikin will be.
72 hours.
72 hours.
Whether it's going to be tall, short.
Whether the pikin go tall or it go short.
Dark colored, light colored.
Or it go black or it go yellow.
Brown eye, blue eye.
Or eye go brown or your eye go blue.
72 hours.
72 hours.
Everything is complete.
Everything not complete.
And now you'll be pregnant 3 months.
And now you don't get belle for 3 months.
You want me to change the sex of the child?
You want
me
to change her from boy to girl or from girl to boy?
She said, are you not the one who told us that if two of us shall agree?
She got to say, maybe you to say, if two people, they can't agree.
I said, hey. He said, Daddy, and I'm not asking you to be the one to do it. All I'm asking for is agree with me.
He say, Papa, I know they told him now you go do one move. What you are just beg for? May you cooperate with me?
Okay.
I can't say okay. Okay.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
I can't say in Jesus' mighty name.
I agree with this girl.
I cooperate with this girl.
That the baby will be a girl.
Say the pikin when they inside this girl belle, he go be girl.
Of course, we know the rest of the story. The baby came and it was a girl.
I believe so. I know the remaining of the story. When woman come born the pikin a girl.
And I'm sure you say, oh, maybe it was a girl all along.
If you don't say the girl, a girl before now.
But then somebody heard the testimony.
And one person can't hear the testimony.
A medical doctor.
This person himself na doctor.
Pregnant for 8 months.
This person when hear the testimony be doctor, he can't get belle, he own at 8 months.
Came and said, I heard the testimony of that lady.
He can't meet me, can't say, I hear the testimony when that lady talk.
I'm married in a house. I already got 4 girls.
They don't marry me, come one asshole, and me had already born 4 girls.
And the relatives of my husband said, if I don't get a boy, the next time they are going to kick me out of the house.
My husband, family, doctor say, if I not born boy, they say they go carry me through away, come up for the house.
I want you to agree with me that it will be a boy.
I want me you cooperate with me, say, this pikin I carry it will be boy.
We've already checked. And it's a girl.
We don't already go check for hospital and again.
Ah. I say, you are a medical doctor.
I say, but you be doctor now.
That of 3 months. Let us not believe it's a miracle, but it's most likely an accident?
The one won't be 3 months. Make we believe in a miracle. If it be mistake.
She said no.
She just said no.
I don't want to hear that.
He said, I don't want to hear that.
Agree with me.
Cooperate with me, make we pray.
The baby in my womb, even though it's been there for 8 months, and we've checked and it's a girl.
The baby went there inside my belly for 8 months, even though we all check, and we find ourselves again.
I want it to come out as a boy.
Make you cooperate with me, pray, make it come out, boy.
Okay, ma.
It's okay, ma.
I agree.
I cooperate with you.
A month later, the baby came, and it's a boy.
After 1 month, the baby can come out. Now, boy.
Stand on your feet.
You gonna stand up.
Join hands with your neighbor.
You gonna go all along with your neighbor.
And lift your voice to the Almighty God and say, Father.
And make gonna go raise our voice up. Gonna say, Baba.
We agree tonight.
We cooperate tonight.
That every prayer we shall pray this year.
Say every prayer we will come pray this year.
Shall be answered by fire.
By fire you will be answered.
Come on, talk to the Almighty God.
Make you now talk to Papa.
We agree tonight.
We can't agree tonight.
Every prayer we shall pray this year.
Every prayer we will pray this year.
Shall be answered by fire.
Make you use fire to answer.
We are in agreement.
We cooperate together.
All of us.
Every one of us.
We are in total agreement.
We cooperate together. Oh.
That every prayer we shall pray this year.
And we will pray every prayer we will pray this year.
Shall be answered by fire.
Make you use fire. Answer.
Every prayer.
Every prayers.
Every prayer.
Every prayers.
That we shall pray this year.
We will pray this year.
Shall be answered by fire.
Make you use fire. Answer.
Oh yes, Lord.
Yes, sir.
We are in total agreement.
We cooperate together to pray.
Myself and all your children here. That every prayer we shall pray this year.
We your children cooperate to pray. Say every prayer we will pray this year.
Will be answered by fire.
You will use fire to answer.
Immediate answers, Lord.
We want just like just now answer.
That's our agreement.
That be our prayer we will cooperate to pray.
That's our agreement.
Our prayer won't complete the prayer.
We are in agreement tonight. All of us, we are in agreement.
This night, we all of us complete the prayer.
Every one of us here. We agree, Lord.
All of us for you, we agree. Oh.
Every prayer we shall pray this year.
Every prayer we can pray this year.
Will be answered by fire.
And fire you the answer.
Instant answer to prayers.
You will get just an answer to prayers.
That's our agreement. That's our agreement.
Now what do we agree on?
That's our agreement, Lord.
What do we agree on?
That's our agreement.
Now what do we agree on?
This year.
This year.
No delay to the answer to our prayers.
Nothing will delay our prayers.
All our prayers this year shall be answered by fire. We agree.
All the prayer we will pray this year, the fire you will answer.
We are in total agreement, Lord. Every one of us.
We can all agree together.
Our prayer will be answered by fire.
All our prayer, the fire you will answer.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we now pray.
Let us take it a step further.
We could carry one leg, go front.
And say, Father.
And make we say, Father.
We agree.
We agree, oh.
That before the end of this month.
Say, before this month end.
We will all be singing new songs.
Now, new song we're going to sing.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Make him talk to God.
Keep your hands joined together.
Make on our join on our hands together.
Father, we are in agreement.
Father, we agree together.
Before the end of this month.
Say, before this month end, though.
We will all be singing a new song.
A new song all of us will be singing.
A new song of joy.
New song of joy.
A new song of victory.
New song of victory.
A new song of triumph, of success.
A new song sung without succeed.
Of power.
Of power.
Of great anointing.
And say our anointing all day great.
Almighty God. We are in agreement.
Almighty God, we agree with ourselves.
Long before the end of this month, O Lord, we want to be singing a new song.
Almighty God, all of us agree, say before this month ends, a new song we will sing.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
And so it will be in Jesus' name.
Let your amen be in agreement.
Make your amen agree together.
Amen. Please be seated.
Amen. Make us sit down.
That brings me to point number three.
Now you can bring us come number 3 points.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Oh. Daddy says,
Papa say,
of the children who will be born this year,
among the people that go born this year,
at least 1,000 of them will be significant.
At least 1,000 of them will be very important.
That's wonderful.
That one day wonderful.
I wish my wife is still young.
I wish my wife is still young.
Glory be to God.
Glory be to God.
Point number three.
Number 3 points.
God is a businessman.
God not businessman.
He's the ultimate businessman.
Now he be the ogbonge businessman.
He's always talking about increase.
Increase is the only they talk about.
He's always talking about multiplication.
He talk about multiplication.
Genesis chapter 1 verse 28.
Genesis 1 28.
Genesis 1 28.
Genesis 1 28.
The Bible says.
The Bible does say.
So God created man in his own image.
God can create man the way him himself look like.
And then he blessed them.
And he can bless them.
I said, be fruitful and multiply.
May you be fruitful, make you multiply.
Be fruitful and multiply.
May you be fruitful, make you multiply.
After the flood, in Genesis chapter 9 verse 1.
After the many water we will see for Genesis chapter 9 verse 1.
In Genesis chapter 9 verse 1.
Genesis 9 1.
Genesis 9 verse 1.
Genesis 9 1.
When God was blessing Noah.
When God blessed Noah.
Again he said, be fruitful and multiply.
Again he tell Noah, say, make it there fruitful, make it multiply.
In Genesis 17 verses 1 and 2.
Genesis 17 1 and 2.
Genesis 17 verses 1 and 2.
Genesis 17 1 and 2.
When he was introducing himself to Abraham.
When he introduced himself, come give Abraham.
As Jehovah El Shaddai.
He said, I be Jehovah El Shaddai.
The God who is more than enough.
The one who gets everything.
Again, he spoke about being fruitful.
He couldn't see the thought, say, make them be fruitful.
And multiply.
I mean, they multiply.
In Genesis 22. Verse 15 to 18.
Genesis 22, 15 to 18.
Genesis 22, verse 15 to 18.
Genesis 22, 15 to 18.
When he was blessing Abraham. and Isaac.
When he come, he bless Abraham and Isaac.
After Abraham obeyed him and was willing to sacrifice his son.
After Abraham obeyed God to want sacrifice his son.
Before God stopped him.
And God can't stop him.
He said, I swear.
God can't say, he don't swear.
Abraham, I swear.
He said, Abraham, I don't swear.
In blessing, I will bless you.
He said, for blessing, no, I will come bless you.
And in multiplying, I will multiply your seed.
He said, for you to come a born pikin, no, he said, I will make you plenty.
He's always talking about multiplication.
God only they talk about for one person to plenty.
God is never satisfied with you the way you are.
God not dissatisfied the way you be.
Never.
At all.
It doesn't matter how great you are, you can be much, much greater.
You know, get how you can't get money rich. If you get money pass this one.
You cut your own destiny short. If you sit down and say, I can be better.
And you can't do yourself when you can't sit down and say, I never feel better.
No, no, no. God wants to keep on multiplying you.
God, he won't make you plenty.
He wants you to be much bigger than you are at the moment.
He won't make you there big past this level you did.
I still remember when we built the first auditorium near the expressway.
I remember when we come build our church, the auditorium, close to the expressway.
100 meters by 50 meters.
100 meters by 50 meters.
Oh, that was the biggest auditorium in Africa at that time.
That church, that big pass for Africa for that time.
My children came to me and said, sir, we've got the biggest. Let's build a wall around it.
My pikin, no, they can't come. Can't tell me, say, sir, we don't get a big church for Africa. We can't build fence right now.
I say, ah. Where God is taking us, we won't build walls.
I can't tell them, say, where God will take us, we're not going to build fence right now.
When will this place be full?
They come there and say, why people go come full this church?
I said, don't worry yourself.
I said, they don't worry themselves.
2 years later, we had to extend.
After 2 years, we can extend our building.
3 years later, another extension.
After 3 years, we can make another extension.
4 years later, another extension.
After 4 years, we make another extension.
Until we couldn't extend any longer, and we move to the second auditorium.
Until you can't reach points where we not feel you can't extend again. We can't go to the second auditorium.
By the time we move to the second auditorium, hey, now this is where we are going. We have arrived. I say, ha.
When we can't reach the second auditorium, my children can't say, hey, now we don't reach where we go.
We haven't started.
I say, from where? I say, we never start at all.
Then we move to this auditorium. Ah! This is it.
We can't come this auditorium because say, hey, now nah, we don't reach the place.
I said, we haven't started.
I said, we never start at all.
And very soon now we'll be moving to the new auditorium.
You don't go to tell, we can't go to the new auditorium.
And we haven't started.
And we never even start.
How will you know when we have started?
How will I come know when we start?
I mean, the elders who were there then, they remember what I'm saying?
The old people went there among us, so I believe they remember what you had told.
I told you I saw an auditorium.
I tell you, I said, I see one auditorium.
The size of Ibadan.
He big reach the city of Ibadan.
I told them.
I tell them.
They didn't believe me then. I'm sure many of them still do not believe me now.
They not believe me that time. I believe say many of them, even up to now, they not still believe me.
I told them I saw an auditorium where it is buses that will be bringing people to the altar. I told them.
I tell them, say, I see one auditorium when we see a bus, moto, now they carry people, they come altar. I tell them.
How many of you believe that you have not started at all?
I believe so, and I know I start at all.
You better say it with your mouth. I have not yet started.
Make una talk out to my mouth, say, and I know I start.
Now, when you read the story of the talents,
if you can't read the story about the talents
in Matthew 25,
from Matthew 25,
verse 14 to 30,
14 to 30,
Matthew 25, verse 14 to 30,
gives.
one fellow five, he gave another two, he gave one fellow one.
But inside the Bible, they give one servant five, they give another one two, they give another one one.
When he came back, he asked them to come and give the records.
When the master can't come back, can't say, I'm not going to give reports.
The one with five said, it has increased to 10.
The one with get five, he said, my own don't increase, go reach 10.
That's multiplied by two.
That's times two.
Say, well done.
See, well done.
The one with two said, my own now is four. Oh, that's all right.
The one with get two, he said, my own got before now. He said, that's okay.
That's another multiplied by two.
That one at times two again.
Hello, the one who got one.
Hello, you won't get one.
He said, ah, I hid it.
He said, I go hide down.
You did what?
He said, what did you do?
He said, I hid it.
He just said, I go hide down.
Ah. He said, at least you could have put it in the bank.
He said, you could not put it for inside bank, man.
So that when I return, I will get an interest.
He said, so when I can't come, the Lord put interest journal for me.
Why did you hide it?
Why you can't go hide them?
God is a businessman. Let that one sink in.
God not businessman, man. May that one enter your head.
Today.
Today.
And I am telling you, you cannot have a better partner.
You know, if you get a bunger partner for business,
you can't have a better business partner than God.
You know, if you get a bunger partner for business, one better pass God.
Look at Matthew 13.
Matthew 13.
Verse 3 to 9.
Matthew 13, 3 to 9.
Matthew 13, verse 3 to 9.
Matthew 13, verse 3 to 9.
He said, if you partner with him.
He just said, if you can't be God's partner.
The minimum interest you can get.
He said, the shrinking interest when you feel get.
Is 30%.
He said, 30%.
30%?
30%.
60%?
60%.
100%.
100%.
That's what he promised.
And what did God promise?
That's why I always tell my pastors, don't waste time when you want to take an offering.
And make me not tell my pastors, me and they waste time when they want to collect offering.
You don't need to beg people.
You don't need to beg people.
If they love themselves.
If they like themselves.
They will know no better business partner than God.
They will not say, no better business partner be like God.
In 1 Kings chapter 17.
1 Kings chapter 17.
Verse 8 to 16.
Verse 8 to 16.
1 Kings 17 verse 8 to 16.
1 Kings 17, 8 to 16.
The widow of Zarephath had only one meal left.
The woman when her husband not died, when come from Zarephath. Now only one food now again remain.
God said, partner with me.
God said, may you make me your partner.
Give me that one.
Say, give me that food.
And let me show you what I can do.
And make I show you what I can do.
1 Kings chapter 17.
1 Kings chapter 17.
Verse 8 to 16.
Verse 8 to 16.
She gave one meal.
She can't give one food.
And she ate with her family for more than 2.5 years.
No man and her family can't eat for 2 years.
From the supplies of God.
From the supply when God gave them.
In Luke chapter 5 verse 1 to 7.
Luke 5, 1 to 7.
The passage you know very well. Luke 5 verse 1 to 7.
And the passage one I know very well. Luke 1 chapter 5 verse 7.
Peter partnered with God.
Peter can't be God's partner.
Became a partner of Jesus Christ.
Now, Jesus Christ's partner.
A man who had walked all night and caught nothing through a single net.
Yes, when I go fish all through the night too, he can't throw away a net before water.
And caught so much fish.
He can't catch many fish.
Two boats began to overflow.
Until the fish when he catch put one inside two boats, the two boats can sink.
God of multiplication.
God though, now God will make person increase the multiplier.
In Hebrews 11 verse 6, Hebrews 11 verse 6.
Hebrews 11 verse 6. For Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6.
The Bible says God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
The Bible says God is a reward those people when take him serious.
You walk with him.
If you can't follow God, walk.
He will reward you diligently.
God will call reward you well, well.
As you diligently seek him, he will reward you diligently.
As you seek God well, well, God will come bless you well, well.
But there's one thing about this great God, this great businessman.
What is there about God as a man when he's doing business well, well?
If he makes an investment.
If God can't make one investment.
And the investment is not producing profit.
And this investment is not going to bring profit.
It cancels the investment.
You can't cancel that investment.
God is a businessman.
Our God is a businessman.
Luke 13.
Luke chapter 13.
Verse 6 to 9.
Verse 6, verse 9.
Luke 13, verse 6 to 9.
Luke chapter 13, verse 6, verse 9.
He planted a tree.
So we can plant one tree.
In the vineyard.
For where he plant tree.
First year he came, no fruit.
The person can't come the first year, he not see fruit.
Ah. Okay. Maybe it's too early.
Can you say, okay, maybe it's too early.
Second year, no fruit.
He can't come second year, can't collect fruit, he not see fruit.
Third year, no fruit.
In third year, he can't see corn. He can't see fruit.
I told him, gardener, cut it down.
You can't tell the person when they dress the garden. Cut that tree down.
What kind of investment is this?
What kind of investment is this?
First year, no dividend.
First year, you not bring interest.
Second year, no dividend.
Second year, you not bring interest.
Third year, no dividend.
Third year, you not even bring interest.
I say I want to withdraw my investment.
So I want to collect my investment back.
I tell you two stories.
I'm telling you two stories.
Both of them, some of you have heard before.
The two of them, some of you don't hear them before.
Just become general overseer.
You just met me the general overseer.
And I was visiting our parishes.
And I kind of visit our parishes.
We were very many there.
We did plenty that time.
I came to this particular parish, finished ministering.
I can't come this parish, and I preach finish.
And I came and I stood outside.
And I can't stand for outside.
There was this young man who was coming towards me.
One young man, they come meet me.
He was prostrating.
They kneel down, they salute.
Getting up,
they stand up. They kneel down, they salute.
And getting up,
they stand up.
Until he got to where I was.
And he can't reach me again.
And then he dropped something in my pocket, the pocket of my jacket.
And he can't put something inside my jacket pocket.
And began to run.
And he can't run.
And because of the way he was behaving when he was coming.
Because the way they behave when they come.
I quickly want to check what he had dropped in my pocket.
He make me quick want to check what he put inside my pocket.
And it was a 50 kobo note.
And a 50 kobo note that I put inside my pocket.
It was those days when 50 kobo was a lot of money.
Now, those days when we say 50 kobo, yeah, big money with that.
Those days will come back in Jesus' name.
Those kind of days will come back in Jesus' name.
Don't you agree with me?
No, not agree with me.
I know some of you may think it is impossible. Just don't say it.
I know some of you will just say, it's not that possible. I mean, not your stocker.
I said, those days will come back again.
I just said, those days will come back again.
So I called him back.
I can't call him back.
What's the problem? He said,
ask him, what will be the problem?
I heard that.
He said, yes, eh?
Our father and the Lord.
Our papa from church.
Coming.
They come.
And I want to give you a gift.
And I won't give and gift.
But that's all I have.
And only this 50 kobo I get.
How do you give 50 kobo?
How you can't give 50 kobo?
To the general overseer.
To the general overseer.
I said, my son?
Content, I said, my son.
I promise you I will spend this money myself.
I promise you this money, let me go spend on myself.
So that I can bless you from the bottom of my heart.
So if you can't bless you from my heart.
I said, my God will bless you.
Until I say, my God will bless you.
And he went away rejoicing.
And the more he can't come out, he happy.
I think that a year or two later, I was back in the same church.
If I say, after 1 or 2 years, I can't go back to that church.
And I saw the boy smiling.
And I can't see the boy smile.
Coming towards me, this time now, radiant.
The boy smile, he laugh, the waka come meet me.
Daddy, I have a testimony.
Papa, I get one testimony.
Last time you were here, I gave you 50 kobo.
Last time when you come, now 50 kobo I give you.
Because that's all I had.
Now all what I get.
But since then, God has done marvelous things in my life.
Since that time, God has done one big thing for my life.
Now, I have a whole school to myself.
Me, I get one full school for myself.
I said, you have what?
I said, you get what?
He said, when you were here, I had no job.
He said, when you were here, I not get one.
So what I was doing was, I was coaching children after school.
What do they do? And they gather children, they teach them lessons after school.
And then after you say, God bless you, every child in my coaching class came first in class.
After you come tell me, say, God bless me, every picking when they do lesson with you, they come at the first for class.
And parents began to hear about it and they began to bring more children. So many children that I had to be employing teachers.
Many papa and mama come hear about this thing. They come, they bring their picking, they come. The children come plenty. So today, I come, they hire people, maybe they help me, they teach too.
I want to say to somebody on credit.
I want to tell person from credit to
God bless you.
God bless you.
That's one story.
I want to leave that.
Because we are going to pray in a moment.
Because we'll soon pray.
The second one was a sad one.
The second story, now a bad story.
We've had it before.
And I don't hear that before.
A friend of mine came.
But one of my friends come.
Carrying his wife.
He carried a wife come.
The wife was in a coma.
His wife, he just asleep, enough he get up.
The doctors have said there's no hope for her. She's going to die.
The doctor asked to say, I saw the wife go sleep past the die. He said, no, oh.
So she brought her.
She come bring her, come the camp.
When I saw her, I said, oh Lord.
When I see this woman, I can say, oh Lord. Oh.
This family, they are a family friend.
This family, they be friend to our family. Oh.
You must heal this girl. You must heal this woman.
I said, you must heal this woman. Oh.
And the Almighty God spoke to me. I said, son, don't waste your energy. She's going to die.
And God come tell me, say, make you not to waste your time. Oh. This woman, I die, go die.
Ah, no. Hey, Father, you're a merciful God.
Come say, ah, God, you did merciful.
Your mercy endureth forever.
Say, your mercy, that forever and ever, I do.
You don't want the death of sinners. You want them to repent. And I began to quote the Bible to the one who wrote it.
You know what makes sinners die, you? I can't talk Bible to person when be say, na even write Bible.
I lay my hands on her head.
I can't put my hand for the woman's head.
And I felt the anointing flowing like warm oil down my hands.
I can't see the anointing. They flow like cool oil. They pass through my hand to the woman's head.
To the palm of my hand. As soon as it touched her head.
But as soon this anointing touched the woman's head, dude,
it flowed back.
It will flow back into my hand.
I ran to the altar.
I can't run, go altar.
It was the first auditorium there.
And the first auditorium we did that time.
Fell on my face. Please, God, have mercy.
I can't lie down, use my face ground. I said, God, make you get mercy. Please, oh, make you get mercy.
And God said, she's not profitable.
God, just say, this woman, oh, in order to bring profit, come with me.
She's of no use.
She not get use for my kingdom.
I ran back. I lay hands on her the second time.
I run, go back.
Not the same process.
The same process happened.
The oil flowed, hit her head.
The oil flowed, touched her head.
Reversed.
You reversed back to my
head. I ran back to the altar the third time.
I can't run, go altar the third time.
By the time I came back the third time, she was dead.
By the time I can't come back the third time, the woman already died.
Stand on your feet.
Don't you stand up.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God.
Then you can open your mouth, talk to the Almighty God.
I say, Father.
Just say, Father.
I promise to be profitable.
I make promise to say I will be profitable.
Please don't cut me off.
Please do not cut me off.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Make you continue to talk to God.
I promise to be profitable.
I promise I will be profitable.
Don't cut me off.
Make you not cut me off.
Don't cut me off, Lord.
No, they will not cut me off.
I promise you, Lord, I will be profitable. I will be profitable.
I promise you, Baba God, say I will be profitable.
Please, don't cut me off.
Please, do not cut me off.
Oh, Lord, please.
Oh, Lord, please.
I promise I'll be profitable.
I promise I'll be profitable.
I'll be profitable in every way.
I'll be profitable for every way.
Don't cut me off, Lord.
Please do not cut me off.
Don't cut me off.
Not cut me off.
I promise you, Lord, I will be profitable.
I promise you, say I'll be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I'll be profitable.
Don't cut me off, Lord.
Not cut me off.
Please don't cut me off.
I beg, not cut me off.
Don't cut me off.
I beg, don't cut me off.
Don't cut me off, Lord.
I beg, don't cut me off.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
From now, I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I will win souls for you on a daily basis.
Every day, I will win souls for you.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I will cease to be without profit.
I will stop to be that person when I'm going to make profit.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
Lord God Almighty, I will be profitable.
Lord God Almighty, I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I promise you, my Father and my God, I will be profitable.
I promise you, Baba God, I will be profitable.
Don't cut me off.
Don't cut me off.
Don't cut me off.
Don't cut me off.
Please, Lord, don't cut me off.
Please don't cut me off.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
I will be profitable.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Now lift your hands to him.
Now you carry your hand, go on.
And say, Father.
And you say, Father.
Let your work prosper by my hands.
Let your work prosper for my hand, though.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Make on talk to God.
Please, Lord, let your work prosper by my hands.
Please, God, make your work prosper for my hand.
Let your work prosper by my hand.
Make your work prosper for my hand.
Let your work prosper by my hand.
Make your work prosper for my hand.
I beg you, Lord.
I beg you.
Where are my hands?
This is my hand, O.
I surrender them to you.
I give them to you.
Let your work prosper by my hand.
I surrender my hand to you. Make your work prosper from my hand.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
So it will be in Jesus' name.
Please be seated.
You can sit down.
That brings me to point number four.
Then come bring me come number 4 point.
Divine involvement.
When you come there involved for what God will do,
puts an end to losses.
It will cost you making not a loss at all.
Divine involvement puts an end to losses.
When you there involved for what the God own will stop you. Not to lust at all.
In John chapter 5.
For John chapter 5.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Baba.
The Lord said there is a woman here.
God just said, one woman there.
That the pain in your womb is like fire.
The pain when they pain you inside your womb, it's like fire.
Ask me to tell you the fire is gone out.
Make I tell you, say that fire don't come out.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Baba.
Ah, this is good.
This one they're good, you know.
Daddy said there's someone here tonight.
Baba said one person there here.
He said those who are trying to hinder your progress.
He said those people that try to block your progress.
We watch helplessly.
They watch you and they don't go if you do anything.
As you draw nearer and nearer your goal.
When you go closer, they go closer to your goal. They
will just be watching.
They will just be watch.
And they won't be able to stop you.
They're not going to stop you.
They will just be watching helplessly as you draw nearer and nearer your goal.
Because they watch you without enough you do anything as you go closer to your goal.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, you.
In John chapter 5.
For John chapter 5.
verse 2 to 9.
For verse 2, glorious
9. John 5, verse 2 to 9.
John chapter 5, verse 2, glorious 9.
Is the story of the man by the pool of Bethesda.
Now the story about one man when they one pool where they call Bethesda.
This man has lost 38 years of his life.
This man, he does spoil 38 years of his own life.
38 years.
38 years
of his life.
For his life.
Until Jesus Christ came in.
Until Jesus come.
And the loss ended.
And the loss, when the loss, it come end.
38 years.
38 years.
I still remember several years ago.
I still remember many years when they passed.
When I went to visit one of our prisons.
When I can't go visit one of our prisons.
And they introduced a man to me who had been prison, sentenced to death.
And they can't show me one man when they said they not sentenced to death.
And he had been on prison for 30 years.
And he done the prison for 30 years.
30 years.
30 years.
When he told the story, my heart bled.
When he can't tell me the story, I can't sorry for him.
He said, sir, they execute those they are going to execute early in the morning.
He said that they kill people when they want to kill for early in the morning.
Usually between 3 and 4 a.m., if I remember correctly.
He said that between 3 and 4 in the morning, if I remember correct.
He said, so all these years, I have not slept at night until after 4 a.m.
He said, all these years when they pass through, suddenly they feel they sleep until 4 a.m. they pass for morning.
If I don't hear footsteps coming towards myself by 4, I know they are not going to kill me that day.
If I don't hear people, the waka, they come, they say when I did that day, they don't kill me.
For 30 years.
For 30 years.
I came out of the place.
I can't come out from that prison.
I cried to all the people that I can cry to.
And I can't cry, go meet all those people when I feel go cry, go meet.
And by the special grace of God, they release him.
And by God's grace, so they can release that man.
All the years that you have wasted,
all the years when you don't waste,
shall be fully restored to you in Jesus'
name. All the years when you don't waste, God will give you again in Jesus' name.
In Mark chapter 10.
Mark chapter 10.
Verse 46 to 52.
46 to 52.
Mark 10, 46 to 52.
Mark 10, 46 to 52.
It's the story of Bartimaeus.
Now, story about Bartimaeus.
He had lost 40 years of his life.
This man, now 40 years.
In total darkness.
Now he knows the sea.
40 years. As a beggar.
Now 40 years, he can't beg.
Until Jesus came in.
Until Jesus can come.
And all of a sudden,
and at once,
light came.
Light can come.
In Luke chapter 5.
For Luke chapter 5.
Verse 11 to 15.
Verse 11 to verse 15.
Sorry, Luke 7 rather. Luke chapter 7.
Luke chapter 7.
Verse 11 to 15.
Verse 11 to verse 15.
Bible tells us about the story of the widow of Nain.
The Bible can't tell us about one woman who come from Nain when lost her husband.
Who had an only son, and that son died.
And he can't get only one boy picking, and that boy picking can't die.
In her family, it had been one death after another.
For this man's family, now one by one did he die.
The husband died.
The woman's husband died.
Now the son is dead.
Now the boy picking don't die.
Loss of husband.
She lost her husband.
Now loss of son.
Now she got the lost her son.
Until Jesus came in.
Until Jesus can't come inside.
And the tide turned.
And things can't turn around.
One young man came to us several years ago.
One young man come meet us many years ago.
He said, Daddy,
he come tell me, say, Papa,
I'm approaching 40 years of age.
I want to reach 40 years now.
I said, congratulations.
Come tell and say, congratulations.
He said, that's not why I'm here.
It's not the reason I come.
He said, I'm the oldest man in my family.
It's not me who passed on my family.
Nobody in my family ever went beyond 40 years.
You say nobody for inside my family went past 40 years.
They just kept on dying whenever they were approaching 40.
They go just die when they want to reach 40.
I said, in the name of the one who made heaven and earth, your own will be different.
I can tell and say, in the name of the one who make this heaven and the earth, your own will be different.
That's more than 20 years ago.
And now we're not past 20 years.
He's still alive and well.
This brother is still there alive and he's still there camping.
In the family of somebody here tonight, no more death.
For one person family this night, too, nobody go die. You.
In 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 7.
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 It tells us the story of the sons of the prophet.
It will tell us about a prophet speaking.
Who came to Elisha and said, "Sir, where we are is too tight for us."
They come meet Elisha and they come tell and say, "Oga, where we dey? It's not there too tight for us.
Give us permission to go to Jordan."
He said, "Make you give us permission, make we come go Jordan.
Get some wood.
Make go gather wood
and build a bigger tent." He said, "Fine, go.
Make come be big place where we fit stay." He said, "If they good, go
and
go."
And they said to him, "Please come along with us."
They come beg and say, "Oga, please, follow us, go."
He said, "Okay, I will come."
He said, "Okay, I will follow now."
The Bible said as they were cutting down tree,
the Bible can't tell us, say, as they cut down the tree,
the axe head fell into the river.
The axe head, when you say cut the tree, can't fall inside water.
And one of the sons of the prophet said, "Alas, master, we borrowed it."
And one of the prophets speaking can't say, "Oga, now borrow, we borrow this axe too."
And they borrowed the axe.
They go borrow axe.
And now it is in the bottom of River Jordan.
And now bottom of River Jordan, where the axe there.
And they couldn't swim.
And enough to swim.
But then the man of God said, "Show me where it fell."
The man of God can say, "Show me where it fell, put."
And they showed it.
They can show him.
They cut a piece of wood.
They can cut one stick.
Threw it into the river.
They can't throw inside the water.
Because of the anointing in the hand of the man of God.
Because of the anointing when there is man of God and
the wood that's supposed to float.
The wood was supposed to float.
Sank into the bottom of the river and began to look for the iron head.
He can't sink, go down, can't go look for the iron head.
When he found the iron head, he transferred the anointing to the iron head.
When he can't see the iron head for under the water, he can't transfer this anointing, give the iron head.
And the iron head jumped up and began to swim on the face of the river.
The iron head can't jump up, come on top of the water, and he can't start to swim.
When God intervenes in your situation,
when God can't show up for your matter,
he can reverse the irreversible.
He will come turn waiting, like I said, enough he turn around, he can't turn out for your favor.
That will be your testimony before the end of the month.
That one will not be your testimony before this month will end.
Some of you will remember the testimony of one of our sisters.
Some of you now go remember the testimony when one of our sisters gave.
I remember whether she gave it here or in the other auditorium.
A lot of you remember whether I hear and give that testimony. I've been at the second auditorium, he go give the testimony.
She was sacked illegally in her place of work.
They sacked her without she not do anything for her place when she did work.
So she took them to court.
Stop carrying them, go court.
And because they were a very big company.
Because this company big well.
They began to maneuver.
They got a play with you.
Through their lawyer.
With their lawyer.
And they kept on postponing the case. Adjourning the case, adjourning.
They can't postpone this woman case from one day to another date.
For 17 years.
17 years. Then they postpone this case.
The poor woman sat down at home.
This woman sat down for house.
While the lawyers were playing their games.
Why these lawyers, they play their games?
And one day she came to the Holy Ghost service like this.
And one day this woman can't come Holy Ghost service like this.
And God spoke.
And God can't talk.
God mentioned her case.
God can't talk her case.
May God speak to your case tonight in Jesus.
May God talk to your case tonight in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Daddy.
Thank you, Papa.
He's speaking to the case of someone.
They talk to one person's case.
God said, Your business shall come out of the coma.
He said your business will come wake up from the sleep when they sleep.
God spoke to our case and said,
God can't talk to that woman's case. Can't talk, say,
there's someone here, you have a court case.
He said, one person there here won't get court case.
Next week, the case will be decided in your favor.
Next week, they can't conclude the case and then you come win.
And she jumped.
And this woman can't jump up.
The following week,
the second week,
they got to court.
They can't go court.
The lawyers began their maneuver again. And the judge said,
the lawyer, they don't start to play while you again. And the judge can't say,
thank God that there is a judge that is the judge of the universe.
Thank God said they get judge when they judge the whole earth.
The chief judge of heaven.
Chief judge when they heaven.
Spoke on Friday night.
He talked on Friday night.
The following week.
The second week.
The judge said,
the judge can't say,
no more adjournment.
Say they're not going to adjourn this case again.
I'm giving my ruling now.
I go talk my judgment now.
You serve this woman illegally.
You serve this woman without she not do anything.
I hereby rule.
I go call Tosse.
That you pay her for the 17 years that she's been at home.
You go call pay her for the 17 years when she does sit down for house.
Together with interest.
Together with interest.
Stand on your feet.
We can stand up.
Join your hands together.
We can put our hands together.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God and say, Father.
We can open our mouth. We can say, Papa.
Step into my case.
Let you come inside my case.
Reverse the irreversible.
Make you turn that thing when I say no, if you turn.
Go ahead. We all agree.
Make you pray. All of us agree.
Father, step into our cases.
Papa, make you come inside our case.
Reverse the irreversible.
Turn that when I say no, if you turn.
Reverse the irreversible.
Turn that when I say no, if you turn.
Reverse the irreversible.
Turn that when I say no, if you turn.
Reverse the irreversible, Daddy. Reverse the irreversible.
Papa, turn that to when I say enough, you turn.
Step into my case.
Come inside my case.
Reverse the irreversible tonight.
Make you turn that to when I say enough, you turn this night.
Reverse the irreversible, Lord.
Turn that to when I say enough, you turn tonight.
Reverse the irreversible.
Turn that to when I say enough, you turn
tonight.
Tonight,
my Father, my God. Reverse the irreversible.
My Papa, my God, turn that to when blessing of it on.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Papa.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
And please join hands together still.
They're gonna still join in your hand.
And pray this one with all your heart.
I'm gonna come pray this one with all in my heart.
And say, Father.
I'm gonna just say, Father.
We agree.
We don't agree.
No more losses.
You're not going to lose again.
Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God.
Look at the beginning of prayer.
No more losses.
We're not going to lose again.
Father, no more losses. No more losses.
Father, we're not going to lose again. We're not going to lose again.
We agree.
We don't agree.
We are in total agreement.
All of us, we agree.
We are in one accord.
We cooperate together.
Father, No more losses.
We say we're not going to be lost again.
No more losses.
We're not going to be lost again.
We are all in one accord.
All of us cooperate together.
No more losses.
We say we're not going to be lost again.
No more losses. We are saying loud and clear, Lord, hear us. No more losses.
We say we're not going to lose anything again. We will talk loud and clear. Oh God, hear us.
No more losses.
We're not going to lose anything again.
No more losses, Lord. No more losses.
We're not going to lose anything again.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we now pray.
And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
And so it will be in Jesus' name.
Please be seated.
Make us sit down.
Maybe before I continue, you should tell your neighbor, no more losses.
Before I go continue, make you tell your neighbor, say, I'm not going to lose anything again.
Say it as if you believe it.
Make you not talk and like say you're not a believer.
That brings us to point number 5.
I will carry us to point number 5.
Oh, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Baba.
The Lord said there's someone here.
God said one person there. Yeah.
He said your vision that was becoming blurred.
Your eye when you know they see clearly again.
Shall begin to clear steadily from
now. He said you're going to see clearly from now on.
Ah, thank you, Daddy.
Thank you, Papa.
The Lord said the fellow here. This fellow will understand.
Say the person will understand.
He asked me to tell you the itching is gone forever.
He said that scratch, scratch, it all go forever.
Thank you, my daddy.
Thank you, my papa.
Daddy says there's someone here tonight.
My daddy said someone there tonight.
He said last year you were facing 3 mountains.
He said last year you were facing 3 mountains.
He said one is gone.
One don't go.
And the other two will follow quickly.
He said the other two quick they go still go.
Point number 5.
Number 5 point.
Because God is the ultimate businessman.
Because God now don't get businessman.
And when he gets involved, losses ends.
And when he can't come inside, we're not going to lose anything again.
The Bible that he gave us.
The Bible when he can't give us.
Is a book of prophets.
That book when they bring gain.
In the text that I read, Isaiah 48 verse 17.
For the book, what would I read? Isaiah 48 verse 17.
Isaiah 48 verse 17.
Isaiah 48 verse 17.
He said, I'm the Lord thy God, we teacheth thee to profit.
The Bible does say, now me be your God. What they teach you, make you feel make gain.
The Bible is a book of prophets.
The Bible. That book where they bring gain.
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16.
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16.
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16.
2 Timothy 3 verse 16.
Says all scriptures were given by God and is profitable.
He said everything when they inside the Bible, now God now give them and to make gain.
The Bible is a book of prophets.
The Bible is a book where they bring gain. Again.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 9.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 9.
Ecclesiastes 5 verse 9 says.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 9 says.
The profit of the earth is for all.
He said the gain when they inside this earth that everybody now get on.
The profit of the earth is for all.
The gain when they inside this earth that everybody now get on.
So the question then is.
So the question we'll come ask ourselves.
Why are some people suffering losses?
Why some people they suffer?
How come some people are prospering from the profit of the earth?
Why is it some people that they enjoy from the gain when the earth they give?
And some people are suffering losses.
Other people, they suffer losses from the same earth.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10.
From the book of prophets.
From the book when they give gain.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10 says.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 10. It was a.
Wisdom is profitable to direct.
Isn't a good thing? But best when know something and in what to do.
Wisdom is profitable to direct.
Person when know something and in what to do.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 11.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 11.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 11.
Ecclesiastes 7 verse 11.
He said, wisdom is good with an inheritance.
He said, wisdom is good when it be say, and from your papa you get time.
By it profit. By it there is profit to them that are under the sun.
And gain come day for person when we say they labor under the sun.
In other words, the difference between those who are profiting and those who are losing is wisdom.
It comes and say the difference when they between people when we say they make them for life, they succeed, and people when we say they fail, they lost. Now wisdom.
And what is wisdom?
And what it can be wisdom?
Apart from being the fear of God.
Apart from wisdom, when be the fear of God.
Psalm 111 verse 10.
Psalm 111 verse 10.
Psalm 111 verse 10 says the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom.
Psalm 111 verse 10. It says, for you to fear God, that there wisdom begin.
What is wisdom? Wisdom is the correct application of knowledge.
What it can't be wisdom? Wisdom means say you know something and you can't know how to do it.
Correct application of knowledge.
You know something and you can't know how to do that thing.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Father asked me to tell you a story.
My papa asked me to tell you one story.
The story is particularly for one fellow.
The story that one person I consigned.
It's a story you've heard again and again.
The story one at all year many, many times.
Years ago.
Many years ago.
I was visiting our church in Ilorin.
I come visit one of our church for Ilorin.
And as I was about to leave,
as I won't come back,
they came to call me.
They come call me
from the maternity center.
People come from the very bomb picking, come call me.
And there was a woman in labor.
I said, one woman there, one bomb picking.
And she had told them,
and the doctor them say
that on the day of delivery, she will die.
The day when she was born picking, and that day she will die.
So I said to her,
I can ask him and say,
is it true you want to die?
The truth say you won't die.
On your day of delivery.
The day when you want born picking.
She didn't answer.
She won't answer me.
Okay.
Okay.
If you want to die, go to the hospital.
If you want to die, go to the hospital now.
You don't come and die in the church.
If you not come here, come die for church.
She says she's not going anywhere.
She just said, I'm not going anywhere.
Okay. So I prayed.
I can't pray.
And I left.
I can't come back to Lagos.
3 days later.
After 3 days, oh,
people came from Ilorin.
People come from Ilorin.
Daddy, the woman you prayed for, after you left, she gave birth to a baby.
They just say, Papa, the woman when you prayed for, after you come out, the woman come bump one pikin.
But we checked and we found that there's still another baby inside her.
We can't check, we come find and say, another pikin sit inside the woman belly.
And we have been praying for the second baby to come. Since then, the second baby had refused to come.
We don't pray since. May the second pikin come. And the second pikin inaugurate come out.
We told her to go to the hospital. She refused.
We don't tell her make she go hospital. She not go.
That's why we are here.
They make us there.
And fear gripped my heart.
Me myself, I can't fear.
Don't mind confessing to you.
I'm not ashamed to tell you now.
As I put up a bold face.
I can't strong my face.
After all, I'm supposed to be general overseer.
After all, let me be general overseer now.
Is that why you are here?
I can't ask them, say, let me go to there.
Who told you that the God in Lagos is different from the God in Ilorin?
I can't tell them, say, who told them, say, the God went in Lagos is different from the one in the Ilorin?
Go back now. Before you get to the second baby will have come.
They go back now. Before I reach out, the second picking will not come outside.
Give them a bottle of Coke each and send them back.
I can't give every one of them Coke. That's me they drink and I send them go back.
After they left, I ran upstairs to my bedroom.
After they let go, I can't run, go upstairs, go my prayer room.
Fell on my face. Almighty God, This is the day of trouble.
I can't lie down, use my face ground. I say, oh God, this is not the day of trouble.
You say, if I call on you in the day of trouble, you will answer me.
You say, if I call you for trouble time, you say, you will answer me.
And God said, so you didn't even believe what you said.
And God can ask me, say, so you don't believe what you talk?
I said, I believe, but I send them away so that I can come back and talk to you.
I can't send them away, go back, so I will feel climb, come up, come talk to you.
God said, if you believe, go and eat.
God said, if you believe, we are going to eat now.
And it was a Saturday and I was fasting in preparation for the Sunday service.
Now Saturday, I did fast, they prepare for Sunday service.
I said, Lord, you know, it's Saturday, I'm fasting.
God tell us, say, Lord, you don't say this is not Saturday, I did fast.
He said, go and eat.
He said, go eat.
Well, I ate.
Well, I can't go eat too.
Like I've always told you, whether the food went through my mouth or through my nose.
Yes, I don't tell you now. Whether the food now my nose it passed, or now my mouth it passed.
I can't remember because I was frightened sick.
I'm not going to tell you now because I didn't fear where.
But by the evening, the phone came from Kwara State.
And for evening, they come phone me from Kwara State.
To say that by the time they got home,
they come tell me, say, before they reach home,
not only had the second baby come, the third had come also.
I be say, now only the second baby come out, the third one don't come out too.
And the three of them are doing well, they are wonderful children. I think by now they must be about 30-something years of age.
And the three pikin, they get back. By now, I believe they will not reach 30-something years.
The reason God asked me to tell the story is for one person here.
The reason why God wants me to tell you this story is because of one person.
The Lord asked me to tell you, your covenant to die at childbirth is destroyed tonight.
He said that agreement, so when they don't make sense, when you bump pikin, you go die and I'll destroy him this night.
What is wisdom?
What it be wisdom?
Wisdom is the fear of God.
Wisdom, not to fear God.
But it's also the correct application of knowledge.
Something when you know, the real way to do it.
1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 15.
1 Timothy 4 verse 15.
1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 15.
1 Timothy 4 verse 15.
He said, you must meditate on the word of God.
He said, think God will do
and give yourself only to them,
and may you give yourself totally to God
will, that thy profiting may appear to all,
so that the gain everybody will consume.
Meditate on the word of God,
make you think about the word of God,
give yourself completely to the word of God,
may you submit yourself, give God word,
that is believe it completely.
He means say, make you believe God completely.
Practice what the word of God says.
It's may you put the word of God to practice.
Then your profiting will appear to all.
Then again, when they inside, everybody go see him.
In Joshua chapter 1 verse 8.
Joshua chapter 1 verse 8.
Joshua chapter 1 verse 8.
Joshua 1 8.
The Bible says.
The Bible says.
God said to Joshua.
God don't talk to Joshua.
This book of the law shall not depart from their mouth.
This Bible, the word of God, not supposed to come out from your mouth.
But you must meditate in it day and night.
Make you think about it for day and for night.
He said, then you prosper, you make your way successful.
Then you come make the way when you go for this end, make it day successful.
And then you will see good.
You will see good things.
James chapter 1, verse 22 to 25.
James 1, 22 to 25.
James 1, verse 22 to 25.
James 1, 22, verse 25.
Tells us that the people who will profit.
He tell us that people when be say will make gain.
And not those who just hear.
Not the people when just hear the word of God.
But who are doers of the word.
And people when they do what the word talk.
If hearing the word of God alone can make one successful, everybody by now should be more than successful.
If not only to hear the word of God, that will make you get successful for life. Everybody for this earth will not be successful.
But we hear it, do we practice?
Then we dey hear am. We dey try to practice am.
Failure to practice the word of God is what is causing losses.
For you not to practice what the word of God talk, that make many of us the loss.
Like I told those who came to the Holy Communion service yesterday, and I tell you, get that thing.
What I tell people when come Holy Communion service yesterday, when I try and get that thing.
If God will only open your eyes.
If God will only open your eyes.
To see the losses you suffer.
Make you see all the things when we say you don't get lost to.
Because you won't do His will.
Because you know they follow God's way.
Your life will change.
Your life will, it will change.
Some of you know this story I'm about to tell you. Some of you even know the brother concerned.
Some of you now, when I know this story, when I won't talk. And some of you now, when I know the brother, when this story they talk about.
Daddy, pray for me that I will have a breakthrough. Pray.
Papa, pray for me so that I will come rich. Pray so that I'll get breakthrough. Pray.
And I kept praying.
And I couldn't pray.
One day he came. Aha, Daddy, God has answered your prayer. This one is big.
And one day come. He said, Papa, God will answer your prayer. This one day big.
I said, good. He said, a man in Lagos called him.
He said, one man for Lagos will come call him.
And said, I have this block of flats, 13 flats.
He said, I get 13 flats.
And I want to sell it.
And I want to sell them.
And I'm giving it to you to sell.
And I want to make you go sell them.
Bring me so much.
Make you bring me so and so money.
It doesn't matter how much you sell it for. Just bring me so much.
It don't matter how much you go sell them, but just bring me so and so money.
He came to me rejoicing, said, hey, 13 flats.
He come meet me, they are happy. Say, now wow, 13 good flats.
And I've already found buyers.
And I don't get people when they buy them.
I said, wonderful.
I said, that one better.
I said, that means you will give one flat to God.
I can't tell and say, me say you can't give one flat to God.
He said, why?
He can't say, why now?
I said, the tithe of 13.
I can't tell and say, you know, say the tithe of 13.
It's actually 1.3.
Now 1.3.
But since there's no 0.3 of a flat.
Because flat not get 0.3.
That's why.
I said, that make me.
He said, that's the problem with two pastors.
He said, none of this kind of thing they tire me for pastors.
I've just got a miracle.
He said, I just get one miracle.
And the first thing you think about is tight.
The first thing you think is tight.
He just got angry and left my office. I said, please forgive me. I'm sorry, sir. I'm very sorry.
He converse, waka come out from my office. I come beg and say, I beg you, make you forgive me. I said, sorry.
The following day, he went to the man.
The second day, he come go meet the man.
Yes, sir. I'm ready to pay the money you asked me to bring for the house.
Okay, I don't come pay the money when you toss me can bring for the house.
That one said, which house?
The man come to say, which house?
Your house at number so.
The house for number so.
The one you said I should sell at any price, I should bring you so much. He said, me?
Make I sell any price I like, and I bring you so and so amount. The man said, me?
I told you to sell my house.
He said, I tell you, so you go sell my house.
And bring me so much.
And bring me so and so amount.
He said, the one who did the charm for you has failed.
He said, that man went to the juju for you, the man will fail.
Me? If you don't get out of here, I will get you arrested.
He said, me tell you that what? If you don't come out for here, I will call policemen and come arrest you.
So he ran back to me.
This boy can't run, come meet me.
Daddy, please. Leave me out of it. Oh.
Papa, he said, please. I said, no. Not put me join this matter.
Go and meet God. Not me.
Make you go meet God yourself. Not be me.
Stand on your feet, my brother.
Make stand up, oh my brother.
Stand on your feet, my sister.
Make una stand up, oh my sister.
And lift your voice to the Almighty God. I say, Father.
Mona can't open on her mouth. And I can't say, Father.
The hearing ear.
The ear when they hear.
And the doing heart.
And the heart when they do things.
Give to me, oh Lord.
Make you give me, oh God.
I don't want to be just a hearer.
I don't want to be person just a hearer.
I want to be a doer.
I want to be person they see they do and too.
The hearing ear.
The ear when they hear.
and the doing heart.
And the heart when they do what he hear.
Give to me, O Lord. Give to me, O Lord.
Give to me, O Lord. Give to me, O Lord.
Do give to me, O Lord.
Give to me, O Lord.
I don't want to be just a hearer. I want to be a doer.
I don't want to be person when just a hearer. I want to be person when also a doer.
Not just a hearer, but a doer of your word.
Not only person when they hear, but person when they also
a
doer.
A doer of your
person
word.
Person when they do according to your word.
Not just hearer.
And I just want to hear your word.
I want to hear and I want to do.
I want to hear your word and I want to do according to your word.
That my profit may be evident to all. No more losses. I want to begin to profit from now on. Give me a hearing ear and a doing heart.
So that everybody will see the gain on the inside. I don't want to lose again, no. I want to make gain from now on. Give me that ear when they hear.
A doing heart.
The heart when they do according to your word.
Not just hearer.
I don't want just the hearer.
But a doer.
Then I want to do your word.
Thank you, my Father.
Thank you, Papa.
Glory be to your name.
Glory to your name.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
And so it will be in Jesus' name.
Let me be seated. I want to round up.
Make you come sit down. I want to round up now.
So what am I to do so that I will never suffer a loss?
Now what in I can't do so I'm not going to suffer loss again?
What am I to do?
What in I will do?
1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8.
1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8.
1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8.
1 Timothy 4 verse 8.
Says, godliness is profitable unto all things.
Say person when they live godly life, he go gain them for everything.
Godliness is profitable unto all things.
Say person when they live godly life, he go gain them for everything.
Having promise of the life that now is,
we can't get the promise, say for life one will get now.
And of that which is to come.
And that life one will can't get forever.
Godliness. That's number one.
For person to live godly life, that means number one.
Stay away from sin.
Don't come out from sin.
Live godly.
Making you live godly life.
One brother came and said, sir.
One brother can't tell me, come to say, sir.
Every time I'm on the verge of a breakthrough, it slips out of my hand.
Anytime I don't reach the time when I go make him, I'm surprised, say, are you all lost time like that?
I said, let us pray.
I said, yeah, make me pray.
As I close my eyes to pray.
As I can't close my eyes, make I pray.
God say, ask him.
God say, make I ask this brother.
What does he do whenever there is a breakthrough coming?
You can't say, ask and say, what do you tell me? No, you don't say breakthrough.
Let's stop the prayer. Because I don't pray prayer that God will not answer.
I'm not going to stop the prayer. Tell me. Because I know they pray prayer when God will answer.
God asked me to ask you, what do you do anytime a breakthrough is knocking at the door?
God said, I can ask you, say, what do you do? Anytime when he say you won't make him,
and he bowed his head,
he can't put his head down, he look around.
He said, before any miracle is complete,
before I go make him,
I commit adultery.
I go sleep with woman, one of my wife.
Ha, ha.
I can say, yeah.
Godliness is profitable unto all things.
For you to live a godly life, it bring profit, it bring gain for everything.
When we ask you to be holy, it's for your own good, so you stop suffering losses.
When we tell on us, make on our day holy, now for our good.
1 Samuel 15 verse 22. 1 Samuel 15 verse 22 says, to obey is better than sacrifice.
1 Samuel 15 verse 22. 1 Samuel 15 verse 22. He said, for you to call obey is better than making a due sacrifice.
Obey God.
Make you obey God.
In all things, obey God.
Make you obey God for everything.
Deuteronomy 28 verse 1 to 2. Deuteronomy 28 verse 1 to 2.
Deuteronomy 28 verses 1 verse 2. Deuteronomy 28 verses 1 verse 2.
He said, if you will hearken.
He said, if you will agree
diligently.
Well.
To the voice of the Lord your God.
For what is God's talk?
To observe and to do all that he commands you.
To come do all what God commands you.
He said, blessings will pursue you and overtake you.
He said, blessing you, you're going to run, follow you, and you're going to overtake you.
Blessings, not losses.
He said, blessings will not be lost.
Obey him.
Obey God.
Stop robbing him.
Let you stop the steal from God.
Malachi chapter 3, verse 8 to 11.
Malachi 3, 8 to 11.
Malachi 3, 8 to 11.
Malachi 3, 8 to 11.
Many of you don't like it.
Many of you are not like him.
It's too bad.
It ain't too bad, bro.
I've said it. If you don't like Malachi chapter 3, tear it off from your Bible. It will still be in millions of Bibles.
I'm not telling you now. If you don't like Malachi chapter 3, verse 8 to 11. Make you tear and come off your Bible. You can see there inside millions of Bibles.
You cannot live under the curse of God and expect to make profits. It's not going to happen.
You're not going to live when God don't curse you and you come to say you come get gain. It's not going to happen like that.
When another human being places a curse on you, it is to destroy you.
When another human being can't curse you, not to destroy you with that.
Not to talk of the curse of God.
Talk less of God's curse.
Whereas the blessings of the Lord make it rich.
Why? Blessing when God give, we make person a rich.
And not there no sorrow.
And no sorrow there inside at all.
Honor him.
Make you honor God, oh.
It's for your own profit.
Not for your own good, oh.
In 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 30.
1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 30.
1 Samuel 2 verse 30.
1 Samuel 2 verse 30.
Those who honor me, I will honor.
He said, people when me say they honor me, not them I go honor.
I told you, the summary of the teaching of Jesus Christ is nothing goes for nothing.
And I'll tell you now, say, all what in Jesus Christ teaching day about, say, me say, nothing, no, it go for nothing.
You honor me, I will honor you.
If you honor me, I will honor you.
You love me, I will love you.
If you can't love me myself, I will love you.
You draw near me, I will draw near you.
If you draw near me, I will draw near you.
You obey me, I will be your friend.
If you can't obey me, I will come be your friend.
So when he said in Proverbs chapter 3 verse 9 to 10.
When he can't talk for Proverbs chapter 3 verse 9, go reach 10.
Proverbs 3 verse 9 to 10.
Proverbs chapter 3 verse 9, go reach 10.
When he said, honor the Lord with your first fruit.
When he told him, we can honor God with our first fruit.
He didn't stop there. He said, if you do that.
He not stop there. He said, if you can't do that.
I will make sure you have so much blessing, you won't be able to contain it.
He said, I'll come make you get many blessings when we say you know we'll get place when you feed put all of them.
He said it.
Now he talk on.
You know it's one of the prophecies for individuals this year.
You know, say one prophecy when they attach to each person for this year now,
is that a chosen few will receive such a blessing from God, they won't even know how to handle it.
Say some few people. They go come get, God will come bless them. Official, they don't go feel know how to handle them.
Chosen few.
A few people.
How many of you will be among the chosen few?
How many of you now? Any selection.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
And so it will be in Jesus' name.
You know what to do.
But I know what you're going to do.
Luke 6:38.
Luke 6, verse 38.
Luke 6:38, he said, give and you shall be given.
Luke 6, verse 38. He said, make you give because they will give you back.
If you don't give, nobody is going to give you. God will see to it.
He said, because if you not give, nobody will come give you back. because God will not see him that way.
2 Corinthians 9:6.
2 Corinthians 9:6.
That my son mentioned earlier. 2 Corinthians 9:6.
2 Corinthians 9:6.
You sow sparingly, you reap sparingly.
If you can't sow, you can't plant small, small. A small, small thing you will reap.
You sow bountifully, you reap bountifully. We all know it.
If you can't plant plenty, plenty, now plenty things you also harvest.
We've had it again and again.
We don't hear them continuously.
The trouble is that we are applying it.
The main problem is say when you put out of practice.
Are we?
When you do them.
I told you before, years ago.
I'm not telling you before. Many years went up past.
When the biggest naira note was 100.
When our 100 naira are the biggest denomination.
I was in a meeting.
At that one meeting.
And God said to me, "Sir, what kind of pastor do you want to be?"
And God come ask me, say, "My pikin, which type of pastor you want to be?"
I said, "Lord, because I'm a mathematician, I don't answer a question until I understand it."
I said, "Lord, because I'm a mathematician, I know the answer question until I can't understand
that." I don't understand that question.
I don't understand this question. No.
So what kind of pastor would you like to be?
Which kind of pastor you want to be?
Would you like to be the richest?
You want to be the pastor when get money well well?
Would you like to be the best?
You want to be the pastor when be say be the best?
Would you like to be the greatest?
Or you want to be pastor when they great pass everybody?
Richest or poorest?
Rich or poor?
Best or worst?
Best or worst?
Greatest or least?
The person went great or the one with small pass?
There's no choice in that.
No choice inside that one. No.
Richest or poorest?
Rich or poor?
If God asks you to choose, which one will you choose?
If God can ask you to make a choose, which one you will choose?
Best or worst? Which one will you choose?
Best or worst? Which one you will choose?
Greatest or least, which one will you choose?
Great or the shikiri one, which one you will choose?
So I chose like you.
I can't choose like you.
And you kept quiet.
And God came quiet.
And after some time, there was another meeting. He said it was offering time.
After that time, we can't get another meeting. I got come to say, no, offering time.
He said, "Son, how about giving the largest denomination in your pocket?"
God come to say, "What about make you give the biggest money for your pocket?"
I almost said, "Get thee behind me, Satan."
And then he want to say, "Satan, go my back home."
Because 100 naira note in those days.
Because that time, 100 naira note, a very big money.
At that time, the naira was more powerful than the dollar. So you understand.
That time, one naira is plenty past $1. I believe so, I can't understand.
But I said, "Yes, Lord."
But when I know it, I can't say, "God, you are here."
Not too long after that, I was at another meeting. He asked the same question, "What kind of pastor?" Now I know the question. I gave the answer. He said, "How about we doubling what we have started to give?"
In order to say, I can't go another meeting. He can't ask the same question. He said, "Which kind of pastor you want me?" Now I know the answer when I will give. He can't tell me, say, "What about you can't give double times the amount when they say you didn't give before?"
I said, "Yes, Lord."
I say, "Yes, Lord."
Even though the "Yes, Lord" wasn't very loud.
Even though the way I talk the "Yes, Lord" is not loud.
Not long after that, he said, How about us tripling it?
Not to say. He can't say, "What about make we make them 3 times?
And none of a sudden.
And at once.
He opened the floodgates.
He can open the many gates.
People will just come and just look at me and say, "We want to give you something."
Some people will just come. Don't you look at me? They say, "I won't give you something."
Thank you very much.
I say, "Thank you very much."
A woman came in October. I said, "I feel like giving you something." I said, "What for?" He said, "For Christmas."
No woman can't come for October. He can't say, "He just said my mind make I give you something." I can't say for waiting. He can't say for Christmas.
This is still October. Well, I just want to give you.
I can't tell him, I say, "Now October we just do." He can't say, "Well, I just want to give him, more.
You give, you shall be given. God will see to it.
If you can't give, he will give you back. God, not the money to that one.
The reason why many of us are dying financially is because we are too stingy.
The reason why many of us not get money at all now because we find it difficult to give out money.
The Bible is given to make you profit.
The Bible will not give us so that it will bring gain. Can give us.
Galatians 6 verse 7 says God be not deceived. God is not mocked.
It does say, make one another deceive on ourselves. God, you're not going to feel laughing.
Whatsoever a man sows, that shall he also reap.
So what do you plan to, now you go reap.
Is there.
In the Bible.
We've been reading it all these years.
We don't even read them all these years.
Only that we will begin to apply it from tonight.
But now from tonight we will start to be doing.
And there will be no more losses.
We will not go lost again.
I didn't hear your amen.
I didn't hear your amen.
What you sow, that's what you reap.
What do you plan to, then you go harvest.
You sow money, you will reap money. I can guarantee you that.
If you can't plant money, then money you go harvest. I will feel, tell you that one for sure.
I have told you the story before.
I'm not telling the story before.
When we started the Holy Ghost service on this camp.
When we start Holy Ghost service for this camp.
I was the only one lay hands on everybody because we were few.
Now only me they put hands for people head because we small that time.
Then we began to increase in number.
And we got in plenty.
And I decided to apply the wisdom of God.
And I can apply God's wisdom.
So I chose 7 elders.
I can select 7 elders.
To begin to join me in ministry.
Then I can join me as I did lay hands for people here.
And I gave each one of them a tithe.
I can't give every one of them one of my tithe.
That I had one. When ministering.
When I know we are before, when I the minister.
I told them, this tithe is soaked in anointing.
I can't tell them, say, this tithe, you. It all soak inside anointing.
You wear it as you minister to the people, and the same anointing will continue to work.
Make one wear them when I minister to the people, and the same anointing when they walk through me, will walk through.
And lo and behold, they began to minister.
As you see, I'm, they call the minister.
And in those days, before I understood how to control the flow, when we lay hands on people. They all fell on the ground.
Before I start to the control this flow of this anointing, but when we put hand for person head, the person before that.
Can you imagine all of you falling on the ground? Where are we going to keep you?
I wanna go see him when we see everybody come church and all of them fall for ground. We won't carry all of them put.
And all of a sudden I discovered that whenever people traveled, whether to London, to America, even to South Africa, when they are returning, they brought me ties.
I can't surprise say everywhere when people travel, whether they go London, whether they go American, even if they go South Africa, and when they come back, they come bring tie, come give me.
So after some time, I said to God, can't these people find anything else?
After some time, I can't ask God, say, these people will not be see anything different from tie to buy for me.
And God said to me, you sow ties, you are reaping ties.
God can't tell me, say, now tie you sow, now tie you harvest.
Oh.
I can say, yeah.
I said, good.
I said, good.
So I look for pastors who have the same shoe size like myself.
I can't look for pastors who get the same size of shoe with me.
And I give them shoes.
And I can't carry shoe with them.
I waited 1 month, no shoe.
I can't wait for 1 month and not see any shoe.
2 months. No shoe.
I can't wait 2 months, no shoe.
3 months, no shoe.
3 months, no shoe.
I say, God, where are my shoes?
I can't say, God, where my shoe?
Thank God is my friend.
Thank God is my friend.
How many friends of God are here?
How many friends of God are there?
This year is going to be glorious for you.
This year go better for you.
Daddy, where are my shoes? He says, son.
Papa, shoe, he said, my picking.
How soon you have a harvest is determined by the quality of the seed you sow.
He said, the time when you go get harvest, it can't depend on the type of seed that you plant.
When you plant maize, you reap it in 3 months.
If you go plant corn, under 3 months, you go harvest it.
If you plant cocoa, you have to wait at least 3 years.
If you go plant cocoa, now at least 3 years you can wait.
Shoes are more expensive than ties. You have to wait.
Shoe, dear pastor, you need to wait.
And then shoes began to arrive.
At once, on shoe can they come.
Black shoes, white shoes, red shoes.
Black shoes, white shoes, red shoes.
Whatever you sow, that's what you are going to reap.
Anything you plant, then you go harvest.
It is the word of God.
And God won't be that.
Win souls.
They're gonna win souls.
And your prayers will be answered.
And God will answer your prayers.
Why?
Why?
John 15 verse 16.
John 15 verse 16.
John 15 verse 16.
John 15 verse 16.
Says clearly.
He can't talk and clear.
You've not chosen me, I've chosen you.
He said, you choose me, but I not choose you.
That you will go and bear fruits.
To make you go, then you go bear fruits.
And make sure your fruits are by that whatsoever you ask the Father.
Then you go preach, you win souls. And what do you call, ask God, make him do.
In my name, shall be done.
For my name, he will do
it. You know what that one means?
You know what that one means?
Work for God, and God will work for you.
Work for God, so God will work for you.
Simple.
So me.
Work for God, and God will work for you.
Work for God, and God will work for you.
Be addicted to soul winning.
If for you to the preach to people, come be part of your life.
You will have testimonies that will baffle the world.
You can't get testimony when we say, when people of the world hear, the thing will surprise them.
I just share one testimony with you and then we'll close.
I want to tell you now one story before we close.
At least I'll move out of your way.
At least I'll come out from that way.
I got my PhD at the University of Lagos way back in 1974.
I can't get one certificate when I call PhD in 1974.
At that time, all universities were universities.
That time, all our university, a better university that time.
I mean, there is no Kabu University there.
That time, no fake university did that time.
And I'm telling you, University of Lagos is a great university.
They tell you now, University of Lagos is the one better university.
I'm sure those of you from that university can agree with me.
And they should say people won't come from that university. And I go agree with
very
you.
Great university.
A better university.
I wrote my thesis.
I can't write much when I call thesis.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Papa.
I want to say amen to this one.
I want to say amen for this one.
And Lord said, there's somebody here tonight. He said, throughout this year.
God said, one person there this night, too. He said, all through this year.
All lights are green.
All lights are green in the show.
Everything is just go.
Everything though, now just go forward, continue.
All lights green.
All lights green.
Now I think it is my turn now.
I can't believe it's my turn now.
Because the Almighty God said there's someone here tonight. He said this year.
Papa God said one person there tonight too. He said this year.
Your son shall shine very, very, very bright.
Your son, he will shine well, he will shine very bright.
Oh. Amen and amen.
Amen and amen.
This one is difficult to believe.
This one will be hard for person to believe.
But if he says it, he will do it.
If God talk, I'm good one.
And I know he's talking to me anyway.
And listen to me to talk to.
He says there's someone here tonight.
He says someone there tonight.
He said before the end of the year.
Before this year go end.
I will double your fortune.
What do you not get? I will double it.
So I wrote my thesis.
So I can't write my thesis.
and submitted.
I come not submit him.
And soon I submitted, I went to Elisha.
Immediately I come submit him, I come go Elisha.
With my father in the Lord to hold a crusade.
With my father in the Lord, go hold crusade.
Crusade in Elisha, crusade in Ifeawara. We were busy.
Elisha, I have to go hold crusade for Ifeawara.
Going from one place to the other, holding crusades.
We move from one place, go another place, go hold crusade.
Unknown to me,
I don't know, say
my head of department has taken my thesis to my external examiner.
My HOD, my guy for my department, he don't take this my thesis paper, go give person when come from another university, make him mark him.
External examiner is somebody from another university who is a specialist in the field where you are.
This external supervisor, the person when me say, is they good for this your field? And you come from another university.
Who will go through your thesis and determine whether it's okay or not?
You go through your paper, you can check whether what you write, is they correct or not they correct.
And usually, it takes its own time.
Before, this work what this person they do, it will take long time because the person will take its time, they'll go through the paper.
And then he will write. If he likes, he can write 6 months, 1 year later. You can't hurry him. He's a specialist.
If he likes, 6 months, then he will give report. Or even 1 year, then he will give his own report. Because now, Oga, now work.
Within 3 days of getting my thesis, he has finished reading.
After 3 days, though, when this expert not take my thesis, go read. He don't read and finish.
And he told my professor.
And he can't tell my professor.
And in case you want to know who was my professor, it was the late Professor Chike Obi.
In case you want to know who be my professor, the late Chike Obi.
It's not an ordinary professor.
I'm not saying not be ordinary professor with that.
It's a professor known throughout the whole world.
A professor who they know for the whole world.
Very, very tough, very strict.
The man, he's very tough. He's strict.
Highly intelligent.
The man, no book one way.
This man told Professor Chike Obi, said, go and give this boy his degree.
This expert contest, Professor Chike Obi, say go give this boy his own degree.
Professor Obi said, what about the oral exam?
Professor Obi Kanto say, what of the exam when you go do, when you go to talk, the answer question with his own mouth?
He said, there's no oral.
This man say, no question like that. They would not go use mouth, they answer question.
That's not done.
Professor Chike Obi Kanto say, so that be so that they do something,
There must be an oral.
Say they must use mouth, answer question.
Before anybody can get a PhD, must have an oral.
Before anybody who can't get this certificate when a PhD, the person must use mouth, answer question.
Part and partial of the whole process.
Now, something what would they do for this program?
This man said, I say I have no questions to ask this man.
Yes, my God say, I don't say I don't get any question to ask this man.
Go and give him his degree.
Go give him his certificate.
Professor Chike Obi came back.
Professor Chike Obi, he can't come back.
Took the matter to the dean.
He can't carry him. Go meet another Oga when big person.
From the dean to the VC.
And from that Oga when big person, go take and go the senior Oga for the school.
They all said the same thing. There must be an aura.
All of them, they talk the same thing. They say they must use mouth to answer questions.
Sit this boy down. If you like, just ask him 2 questions. What's your name?
Say, may you carry this boy, sit down. If you like, now the 2 questions, answer. You ask him, say, what will be your name?
Are you the one who wrote this?
And you can ask and say, now you write this one.
Uh-huh. And after that one, you can say, give him his, but there must be an aura.
Then after that one, if you give him his certificate, better, he must use math, answer question.
The man said, who is the specialist in this field?
The man can answer them. Who be the expert for this field?
They say you are.
It's not you.
He said, I say I have no questions.
He can't tell and say, I thought say I not get any question.
For this boy.
For this boy.
Go and give him his degree.
Go give him his certificate.
Stand on your feet.
Make gonna stand up.
Lift your voice to the Almighty God and say, Father.
Make gonna go open your mouth. Make come to say, Papa.
I will mind your business.
I go do your business, so
please please mind my own business.
Please, sir, make you do my own business.
Open your mouth and talk to the Almighty God.
Make you open your mouth, make you talk to Almighty God.
I will mind your business.
I will do your business, sir.
From now on.
From now on.
Anytime they talk about your business, Lord, I will mind your business.
Anytime they come to talk about your business, I go do one more.
Please mind my own business.
Please, oh, come do my business.
I will do your will.
I go do your own will. Oh.
Anything you say.
Anything you say.
Anything that is in your word.
Anything when they say your word.
I will do it.
I go do one.
I will whistle.
I will whistle.
I will go out on evangelism.
I will go evangelize.
I will do follow up.
I will follow up.
I will mind your business.
I will do your business.
I will build for you.
I will build for you.
Please mind my own business. Mind.
Please do my own business.
My own business.
Please do my own business.
Mind my own business.
Please do my own business.
Almighty God, I promise you.
Almighty God, I promise you.
I will mind your own business.
I go do your business.
Please mind my own business.
I beg, do my own business.
So that my profit,
so my gain,
may appear to all.
Everybody go see him.
Almighty God, give me the grace.
Almighty God, give me that grace.
To mind your business.
To do your business.
While you mind my business.
So that you go come do my business.
I will mind your business.
I go do your business.
From now on, Lord God Almighty,
from now,
I know the secret,
because I don't know the secret,
I will mind your business.
I will do your business.
So you can mind my business.
So you will feed my business.
That way, there will never be losses for me again.
So that I never experience loss again.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, you have prayed. And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
That's how it will be in Jesus' name.
Please be seated.
We're gonna sit down.
Finally.
Last.
Place your times in his hand.
Make you go put your time for God's hand.
Psalm 31 verse 15. David said, my times are in your hands.
David just say, my time, so in dear God's hand.
Just hand over everything to him.
Make you carry everything, go give him.
Hand over everything to him.
Carry everything, give him.
He knows what to do.
He knows what he will do.
He knows how you can profit.
He knows what he will bring profit to you.
Like in the case of Peter, he knows where the fish are.
Like for Peter, Keso, he know the place where the fish they be.
Laboring without him.
For you to come to labor and God not doing well.
It's fruitless efforts.
You not go get results at all.
You just be suffering losses.
And so loss you will suffer.
If you don't cooperate, leave everything to him.
If you not cooperate with him, I beg, leave everything for God.
Place your times in his hand.
Make you put your time for God.
So, if you are here and you have not even surrendered your life to Jesus Christ.
And if you dare here and you never give your life to God.
That's the first thing you should do.
And the first thing what you're supposed to do.
Surrender your life to him.
Make you come give your life to Jesus.
Let him take it from there.
Make you come take him from there.
And let's begin to see what will follow.
Make you come see what will come from.
So if you are here and you have not yet given your life to Jesus and you want to do so.
If you dare and you know why give your life to Jesus Christ and you won't do so,
come quickly.
Make on a Saturday come now.
So begin to come. My sins. From now I will serve you.
Please, Baba God, wash all my sins. From now on, I will serve you.
Be my Lord, be my Savior.
Be my Lord, may you be my Savior.
I surrender my life to you completely.
I give everything, all my life to you. Completely.
Forgive all my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
And just take over completely.
Just take over. May you take over completely.
Talk to the Almighty God.
May you talk to God.
And the rest of us, please stretch your hands towards these people and intercede for them.
The people will remain. Mokona stretch and face these people. Mokona come beg God for their behalf.
Pray that God will save their souls.
When I pray, may God save their souls.
That the one who saved your soul will save their own souls also.
God will not save our soul, may save their soul.
Please pray for them.
I beg, may I pray for them.
Pray for them. Intercede for every one of them.
I beg, may I pray for them. May I beg God for
that
them.
The Almighty Savior.
That God Almighty
will save the soul of every one of them.
Will save all their souls.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Talk to the Almighty God. Lord, have mercy on me. Save my soul.
Make on a talk to Almighty Jesus. Make on a beg and say, oh God, save my soul.
Forgive all my sins.
Forgive me for all my sins, oh.
I'm surrendering my life to you today.
And I give you my life totally.
Complete surrender.
Complete to you.
Just take over my life.
Make you take over my life.
And I will serve you for the rest of my life.
And I will serve you for the remaining days of my life.
Just forgive my sins.
Make you just forgive me my sins, so.
Be my Lord, be my Savior.
Make you be my Lord, be my Savior.
Step into my life.
Come inside my life.
And just take over.
And may you come take charge.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Savior.
Savior.
We bless your name.
We bless your name.
We thank you for your word.
We not thank you for your word.
We thank you especially for these people who have come forward to surrender their life to you.
We can't thank you for these people when they come outside, can't give your life to you.
Please remember your promise.
Make you remember your promise.
But whosoever will come unto you, you will know wise cast out.
Say if anybody come meet you, you know we drive them back.
They have come now.
They not come home.
Please receive them in Jesus' name.
I beg, make receive them in Jesus' name.
Have mercy on them in Jesus' name.
Let you get mercy on them in Jesus' name.
Let your blood wash away their sins in Jesus' name.
Let your blood come wash their sins come out in Jesus' name.
Save their souls.
Let you come save their souls.
Write their names in the book of life.
Let you write their name inside the book of life.
And please, Lord, from now on, anytime they call on you, answer them by fire.
I beg, oh Lord, anytime they can call you, make you answer their prayer with fire.
Don't let them ever backslide.
Make you not let them backslide.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, why don't we talk to God on our own?
Now, may we come talk to God.
Just say, Father,
make you just say, Papa,
take over my life.
Make you take over my life.
Take over my business.
Make you take over my business.
Take over my marriage.
Take over my marriage.
Take over my everything.
Make you take over everything.
I don't want to suffer any loss anymore. Just take over from now on.
I don't want to suffer loss again. Make you just take over from now on.
Give me the grace.
Make you come give me the grace.
To surrender all to you.
Make I will just surrender everything come give you.
To do only those things that are pleasing unto you. Father, just step in today.
Make I do only those things when they're pleasing to you. Father, I will just come inside today.
And take over.
And take control.
So that I will never again suffer a loss.
So I'm not going to suffer loss again.
Go ahead, let's talk to God.
Make we open our mouths more
for a few minutes. While the counselors are attending to these people.
For small time, when the counselor will take attend to these people.
Thank you, counselors. God bless you. We're going to pray one more prayer.
We'll pray one prayer more.
And it's a prayer that is in the form of a seed.
And this prayer, it be like seed.
What you sow, you will reap.
Because what do you plan to when you harvest?
So you please stand on your feet.
I beg you, make on a stand.
Join hands together.
Make you come join your hand with your neighbor.
And this time you pray for your neighbor.
But this time you will pray for your neighbor.
And say, Father.
You say, Papa.
This is your child I'm holding.
This is your pick. pikin na dey home.
Don't let him ever suffer a loss again.
Make you not let him suffer loss again.
Go ahead, pray for your neighbor.
Your mother continue to be praying.
This child of yours.
This your pikin na dey home.
Don't let him ever suffer a loss again.
Don't let him suffer loss again.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Pa.
And so shall it be in Jesus' name.
And so it will be in Jesus' name.
I join my faith with yours.
I put my faith, join your own.
And I say in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
And I toss it in the mighty name of Jesus.
You will never suffer a loss again.
Say you're not going to see loss again.
In every facet of your life.
For every area of your life.
You will never suffer a loss again.
You're not going to suffer loss again.
I declare it loud and clear.
I talk them loud, make everybody hear.
So that heaven can hear me.
So that heaven can feel hear.
Even hell can hear.
Even hell can feel hear.
In the life of every one of you, no more losses.
For all on our life, we're not going to see loss again.
So shall it be in Jesus' name.
That's how it will be in Jesus' name.
Thank you, my Father and my God.
Thank you, Papa.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Almighty.
Amen. Let's put our for Almighty God.